I know what I'm eating for supper tonight. Dandelion salad, worst thing ever. Bitter, horrible tasting. Boy, I tell you, wouldn't go back to those days for all the Hey guys, I'm Guidetti. I hope y'all are doing well today. And I'm not gonna lie to you, this video is going to be a little bit ridiculous. It's the last video of this type that I'm doing, and it's a drawing time-lapse of my friend's godson. And I've chosen to narrate this in my dad's voice. He has a very unique way of talking. This is how he sounds. So I hope y'all enjoy. You gotta start with the basic points and mark the top, mark the bottom, left and right. Use those points to make sure other points are correct. They all gotta line up. Connect those points with straight lines. It's okay to follow through. You can erase the crisscrosses afterwards. Yeah, I tell ya, drawing, you gotta be tough. You gotta stick with it. I learned resilience at a young age. I remember my mother. She used to say to me, "Rich, go outside to the yard and pick me out some dandelions." So I says to myself, "Ah, shit. I know what I'm eating for supper tonight. Dandelion salad, worst thing ever. Bitter, horrible tasting. Boy, I tell you, wouldn't go back to those days for all the tea in China." All right, now we're just working the drawing up like normal. You don't want to panic. Whatever you do, don't panic. I always set it up so that later you can do the details, but you gotta keep it simple at first and correct those mistakes. Get those mistakes out of the way right now. Otherwise, they'll come back, bite you in your ass. Oh yeah. Before I forget, my son told me to tell you that if you like this, subscribe and like. If not, that's okay. He's gonna start doing some videos on painting and shit. So he'll make it worth your time, I guarantee you. Speaking of Lou, I got a story for you. I remember years ago, Lou was walking on the dock and cut his foot. He came in the house complaining about how it hurt. So I just stared at him. And he was whining, complaining, saying, "There's blood." So I says to him, "Yo, wuss." The other day in the OR, a man came in, head completely chopped off. We had to reattach it. And you think he complained about it? Nah. He wasn't a wuss like you kids with your Nintendo. Yeah, I know what you play. Nintendo. Let me tell you something. Back in my day, when I was playing football, we had these big, strong linemen. They used to go days without a shower and eat garlic before a match. They'd get up in your face and they were mean, tough. I remember one time, they broke both my legs. But did I quit? Nah. I kept playing because I was tough. And here you are telling me about a cut. What a wuss. Yeah, sorry. Blacked out. Back to the drawing. All right, we're working on the kid. Hayes is a good kid, real good kid. Never met the kid, but I hear he's a team player, which goes far in my book. He's the godson of my friend John. John's a good guy. Smokes cigars with him every Sunday. He's a team player too. Look, the key to drawing is you gotta keep it simple at first. Keep the line straight, soft, on point. And once you know those shapes are correct, well, that's when you strike. You darken that shit. Refine it. Make it look good. Always fight that urge to detail in the beginning. I know you want to make it look real, and that's why I'm telling you this. And whatever you do, don't get discouraged. This shit is hard, and it's like anything, requires practice, patience, and above all, nuts. Look, if a guy with a stupid name like Leonardo can do it, so can you. Back in my day, a guy with that name would have been shoved in a locker and kept as a pet, alright? So I don't want to hear, you can't do it. Remember another time we had to take a tree down? I went in, got Lou, got Rich. I said, "Lou, Rich, need you, come out here." They said, "Okay." Walk outside, they see the rope up around the tree. They said, "How'd you get it up there?" I said, "Don't worry about it." I said, "Lou, what I'm gonna need you to do, I want you to take that rope and I want you to pull that tree towards you. I'm gonna cut the base of this tree." I said, "Rich, you just stand up top." And he says, "Okay, I'm gonna go get Mom." And I said, "Don't get your mother." So I went through, proceeded to chop the tree down. Lou pulled the tree. Told him to jump at the last second. Wouldn't you know it, the tree fell down. Missed him by an inch, but we got it down. That's how we do it. Not gonna call somebody to go through and chop this tree down. We can do it ourselves. You just gotta be quick, you gotta be smart, you gotta think. Recalling it a couple years back, I was taking apart the shed. Well, had to go through, pull those nails out by hand. I said, "All right, this is just how you gotta do it. They're not gonna come out otherwise." And I would say there was about 10, 12 panels there. So I had to do everything by hand. It took me an hour per panel to take it off. About three panels down, Lou comes out and he says, "Dad, what you doing?" I says, "I'm taking these panels off. What are you doing? Why don't you help me?" He says, "Okay." So he takes the sledgehammer. He says, "I'm gonna try it like this." I said, "You could try it, but I don't think it's gonna come out." It's a lot of work, but you got to do it by hand. Well, wouldn't you know it, he took the hammer and he popped that panel right out. Took him 5 seconds. I looked at him. I said, did it work? He says, yeah. I said, shit. Actually happened.